Hello everyone, welcome to Blockchain Basics, a Practical Approach course. My name is Toshendra Sharma, your instructor. So in this lecture, we'll be going through the definitions. What are the keywords we are going to use during the course? So there are typical some jargons that we'll be using, and I want you guys to follow every time whenever I say this so that it becomes very easy to understand and learn the course during the course. So let's go to our next definition. So first, of course, the most common definition is a blockchain. So in this slide, I'm going to explain the blockchain in a very short, but we'll be covering this blockchain is with the entire course in the separate lecture. So don't worry about this being a very short. So let's build our own definition by understanding it first. So it's a decentralized database which stores information in the form of transactions. So what is database? Just a repository of information or repository of data. So it can be public or it can be private. Yes, it is important to know that it can be public or private. It generally stores data in immutable way, but how? So we'll talk about that, why it is immutable, in a separate lecture. But yes, the data stored in the blockchain are generally considered as immutable, but with a reason, right? So, and it is highly secure. Why? We'll again talk about in the security lecture. Yes, but it is highly secure. It's more secure than the traditional storage. The data gets recorded via consensus-based algorithm. What are consensus-based algorithm? Again, we'll talk about it later on. But yes, there is some proper method using which the data is generally being stored. It uses cryptography. Cryptography is a method of encrypting a data in such a format so that it cannot be read or understood by someone very easily until unless he is the owner or has the key. So that's a cryptography. So blockchain uses cryptography very heavily, and generally it exists over the peer-to-peer network. What is peer-to-peer network? In this lecture only, we'll see in the next upcoming slides. So here is our definition. Blockchain is a consensus-based, secure, decentralized public database which stores information immutably over peer-to-peer network. Some people also call it a public ledger. So public ledger or public database, not the very different thing, but it's quite similar thing. Yes, so that's the blockchain. So let's go to the next slide. What is Bitcoin? So Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency built on top of the blockchain. Remember guys, Bitcoin is not blockchain and blockchain is not Bitcoin. So blockchain is a technology which powers everything, and Bitcoin is built on top of that. Something similar to Records Keeper, which is built on top of the blockchain. So internet is not Google, or Google is not internet. Like Facebook is not internet, right? Or in Facebook is generally built on the top of internet, that is considered. Yes, that's true. So similarly, the blockchain and Bitcoin relation is true, that Bitcoin is built on the top of the blockchain, right? Bitcoin also removes the dependency on trusted third party to execute the transaction. That was the nature of the blockchain. So that's why it is generally considered as a currency which removes the trusted third party requirement. Transaction gets executed by peers based on the consensus based algorithm. Again, the property of the blockchain. Yes, it is recorded in the blocks by the miners. So what are miners? We'll talk in this lecture only. As of November 2016, there are 16 million Bitcoins in circulation, right? So there are limited Bitcoins available in the market, and one Bitcoin is worth currently $730. So it's a very expensive currency right now. And it's like a market share, the Google shares, which are around $400-$500 per shares, something similar to that. So cost generally varies because it depends on many things. So Bitcoin also allow you to execute the transaction without trusting the receiving party. So it means you can, without trusting the receiving party, you can execute the transaction and ensure that that person has received it. You can even claim it. You can prove it that person has received the amount. And yes, even the cross-border transaction can be executed in seconds, unlike days. So here's the definition. Our definition, Bitcoin is a decentralized virtual cryptocurrency built on top of the blockchain. Very simple. What is mining? So of course, earning the Bitcoin, difficult. So there are many ways to earn a virtual currency, any virtual currency, not just Bitcoin. There are multiple virtual currency actually. So simplest way is to buy the virtual currency like Bitcoin using the fiat currency. Fiat currency is like government legal tenders, actual legal currency, through some exchange. There are many exchange in US and other part of the world where you can actually buy the Bitcoins. Another ways to get the Bitcoins are to earn it, or any virtual currency is to earn it through mining by investing your computational power into the blockchain or into the entire network. Right. So what will miners do if they actually mine the particular virtual currency? Let's talk about Bitcoin, right? So what they exactly do? So the answer is that they are asked to solve a very complex computational problem to identify that, you know, that new block is in the blockchain. You know, not exactly the new block. I lost the line. So yeah, so they are actually asked to solve a very computational problem to identify that what should be the next block in the blockchain. So they are actually the miners who will add the block into the blockchain through a certain algorithm. And in return of doing that computation, right, they are rewarded with some virtual coins like Bitcoins, Ethereum, or whatever the related virtual currency is. So in case of Bitcoins, the current reward is 25 Bitcoins. So once you mine one block into the blockchain, right, you will be rewarded with the 25 Bitcoins. So ultimately, what exactly they do? Means, okay, computational power understood, but what is in that computational power? What they actually perform? So the idea is, you know, they identify a particular random number through which they can create the digest or the signature of the next block in such a way that new digest is less than the most recent block's digest, which is very difficult to identify. They have to do so many hit and trials and again, and the 100% of the CPU gets utilized in that process. So that's why, you know, it's a computational intensive process. This is actually generally intentionally made computationally intensive because it is required for the public blockchain to be, you know, difficult. Mining a new block should be very, very difficult. So mining is the process of recording the transaction as a block into the blockchain of that currency. So it can be any currency. So consensus algorithm is just a set of rules to resolve the conflicts. So there must be some conflicts. People should say, nay, this is happening. Why this is happening? Why not that? So who will realize that? Who will actually resolve the conflicts? So that's the idea of, you know, consensus algorithm. It's just a computational methodology or algorithms to resolve conflicts in blockchain. That's called consensus algorithms. What is decentralized? So here is the example. So there are centralized network, there are decentralized network, and there are distributed network. So we are not talking about distributed network, we are talking about decentralized. So the nodes are connected in such a way that they form a cluster of centralized network, but it is not actually completely centralized. And then next is peer-to-peer. What is the next system of peer-to-peer or the server-based? So simple, in the peer-to-peer network, systems are connected to each other in some way, right, directly or indirectly. In server-based, every client is connected to the server, and that's it. Clients do not interact with each other. That's called centralized system or the server-based system, which is the most common. The internet, whenever you serve a website, is a internet-based system, or it's called a server-based system. That's it. So that's for this lecture. If you have any question or query, please ask. Thank you.